And we welcome you back. You know, a bulk of the health news that we've been talking about lately has been COVID related, but St. Louis University Center for Vaccine Development is one of 10 research facilities in the country focusing on something different, and they want your help. We welcome you back outside to our Lakeside Renovation and Design Weather Deck. We are joined by Dr. Sarah George, Associate Professor, Professor of Infectious Diseases and Principal Investigator for the Clinical Trial of Yellow Fever. Good morning to you first, Doctor. How are you?
Good morning. Thank you.
We are happy to have you. Talk about yellow fever. First of all, what is it and why is your department now trying to get a new version of this vaccine going?
Yellow fever is a virus spread in the tropics by mosquitoes in South America and Africa. Can be a very nasty disease, attacks your liver, which is why it's called yellow fever, can be fatal.
And so there already is a vaccine for this, but you have to develop a new variant of it. Why?
Well, the old vaccine works, but it is made in eggs, and it cannot be used in the very old or the very young. And it takes a while to make. We need one that's easier and simpler to make, and we can use in people who have problems with eggs.
Now, we've heard of mosquitoes testing positive for West Nile virus in Illinois as last week, in fact, but is yellow fever a threat here in the Midwest at all?
Fortunately not. It's only in the tropics, South America and Africa.
So who would be most affected by it here in the U.S.?
People who are traveling to those countries and our military personnel who get deployed to those countries.
Yeah, so they could potentially bring it back and they could get themselves protected if they have this particular vaccine. So you're looking for participants to help with your study here in St. Louis, one of 10 research facilities doing so. Who in particular are you looking for?
People ages 18 to 60. Anyone interested, please call the Vaccine Center at 977-6333.
How many people are you looking for and how long is it going to last?
60 people, 5 years.
5 years. And so what are they going to have to go through over those 5 years?
Well, they will either get the newer vaccine or the existing vaccine, and then we do blood samples about every 6 months for 5 years to make sure that they are developing antibodies and how high those antibodies stay.
Interesting stuff always happening in your department at SLU. We thank you for joining us once again. And if you are interested in perhaps participating in this study, you see the information on your screen, vaccine@slu.edu, and the phone number is right there. So give them a call if you're interested or if you know somebody else who might be. Of course, we'll have it all on our website as well. Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you.
All right, time to go back out to Tim Izzell, testing a new job this morning. Tim, if I think that, in my opinion, it is the best smelling parking lot in all the land at Deerbergs.